Hello everyone, today I am going to cover a topic called comprehensions in Python, and it's type by giving a simple examples. So what is comprehensions in Python? So you'll be knowing very shortly with help of simple examples. This is the simple syntax for these comprehensions, general syntax for all these. With example you can see how this comprehension is very, how it provides very short and concise way to construct our output result set for a new sequences. So let's start with a list comprehension. So let's do with the example. Suppose I am taking a list A of 10 natural numbers. 10. Okay. Here my requirement is to just print the even numbers. So before list comprehension we used to do with the help of loop. So I will iterate for I in A. Okay. If I modulo 2 equal to 0, then we used to save that result. So let's take one result set of list type so that we can append there. So res dot append the value. And at last we used to get our result set. So let's print that result set. See, what it did is, we only took the even numbers from this list with help of these three lines of code. So with the help of list comprehension, we can do it in a single line. So let's comment out this and try our list comprehension syntax. So let's save that in a result set. So we are doing a list comprehension, then we will take a square bracket for list. So for I in A, and we will give a condition check if I modulo 2 0, then we have to save that I in our result set. This will do the same thing as all the above three lines of code did. So let's print this one. Let's do it for odd number, suppose. So that result will be different in res. See what it did in a single line. Instead of doing this in multiple lines, we can do in a single line with the help of this list comprehension. So this is a simple example of list comprehension. So let's do another example for dictionary comprehension. Suppose I am taking, let's take this as a example, copy and paste. So suppose these are the roll numbers for 10 students. I am taking now marks for 10 students. Suppose someone is getting 20, 30, 33, 45, 90, someone is getting 100, someone 67, someone 99, right? Suppose someone even got 90, let me check, 9, someone again got 100. Now I want to make a dictionary pair from this roll number and marks, with roll number and its corresponding marks. So initially we used to do with the help of loop initially. So let's do it for suppose r comma m in, I have taught you sub g function in my previous class. So if you don't have any knowledge of this g function, then you can watch my previous video regarding this g function. So I am applying g to this roll and marks. Then I want to save this. Okay, suppose I am taking a result set which is a dictionary type. So result for each roll number I will be keeping a corresponding marks. Okay, Let's print and see what. Suppose I'm printing results here. Yes, it's see roll number 1 having its corresponding marks 20, roll number 10 having its corresponding marks 100. So instead of things is in a 3 lines, we can do in a single line with the help of dictionary comprehension. So let's comment out this and apply our dictionary comprehension. Let's save all else in the same variable, suppose res. So we are applying here list dictionary comprehension, so we have to give a dictionary type, and then again we have to iterate for r comma m in, again we have to apply zip function for roll comma marks. Okay, and here happens for each roll number I have to save it marks. So we are done with this dictionary comprehension. So let's print. Yes, let's see. It did the same thing for this. Instead of doing this in a 2 lines, we have done in a single line. So here it looks like similar. So instead of doing this, let's take one more example. By suppose I'm taking a name. Suppose it's only for 5. So that it will be easy to understand. Suppose I'm taking name equal to, suppose taking for light Sattu, Dia, Neha, Guru, and one suppose seat. Now I want to make this as a key and this as a values. So here we will see the power of this dictionary comprehension. So let's do it here. Let me comment over this code. So here we apply this dictionary comprehension. Res equal to, we have to do the dictionary type, so we are taking a dictionary. So for r comma, so here we have to apply a zip function, right? So r comma m in zip function. So here we have to give roll comma. Now we have to give this name and marks for a single roll number 1 in a single value. So we again apply here zip function for name comma marks, and for each roll number I have to save its name and marks, which is saved in n. And suppose I am printing this res results here. Sorry, I got error. That is marks, not mark. See, we did in a single line with the help of dictionary comprehension. This is the most elegant and concise way of helping with the help of this dictionary comprehension. We can do our code in a most and simple and concise way. So let's do an example for next topic, set comprehension. Suppose I have a value, let's take this one as an example. And I am taking a multiple values of, suppose 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 5, 5, 5, 5. So with the help of set comprehension, I want to pick only odd number. Suppose there are odd number, this 5 have occurred multiple of times. So you know the property of set that it keeps only a single value. It doesn't keep the duplicates for any numbers. So here we apply the dictionary comprehension. Suppose again I am saving in a result variable, suppose res. So again we will do in a same fashion, old fashion, like what we did in list comprehension and set a dictionary comprehension. So let's do here or set comprehension, we will do like this. Suppose I just want to keep a odd number, suppose there are many odd numbers, so for I in A, we apply a condition for odd number A, I modulo 2 not equal to 0, then I want to keep in my set. Okay, I want to save that value in my set. So print our result. See what it did is it took only odd numbers, but haven't taken only here multi 5 have occurred multiple of times, so it has kept only one times without keeping any duplicate values. Okay, so next is generator comprehension. Both here generator comprehension and list comprehension are similar. Only one difference is there, that list comprehension uses a square bracket whereas generator comprehension uses a small bracket. But one major difference is that related to memory utilization. In a list comprehension uses a sorry